New allegations, new at 6, fresh allegations, in fact, about an old nuclear facility in Armstrong County.
Some residents of the Apollo area say they developed cancer from exposure to radiation and toxic chemicals at the former Babcock and Wilcox plant. Team 4's Paul Van Osdahl has done the digging on this story.
It may be closed now, but this property in Armstrong County was once the site of the largest private nuclear processing facility in the country. But neighbors and former workers say all the radiation produced here left them poisoned.
A new lawsuit says repeated releases of hazardous and radioactive substances into the area around the plant caused 3 area residents to develop cancer. One of them, Eva Myers, lived 400 feet from the plant. She died of lung cancer 2 years ago. Last year, 365 Apollo area residents and former workers settled another suit against Babcock and Wilcox for $52 million. One of the people who benefited from that settlement was Kathy Tira, who has lived near the plant her whole life. She is fighting colorectal cancer.
The settlements and stuff maybe ease the pain a little bit, but it's not a substitute for good health.
Her mother, Pauline Solava, worked in the plant, known as the Nuclear Materials and Equipment Corporation, or NUMEC. She died at age 44.
My mother went to work, and whenever she was coming out, there were times whenever she would set off the Geiger counter.
2 years ago, she had her mother's body exhumed to see if there was evidence of radiation poisoning, but the autopsy was inconclusive. Still, she is convinced that radiation and toxic chemicals from the plant site have plagued her family and others in the community.
All 3 of my daughters have had some form of cancer.
On the advice of their attorney, the plaintiffs in this lawsuit are not talking. Babcock and Wilcox, the company that used to own this facility, has not yet responded to the suit. Reporting in Parks Township, Armstrong County, Paul Van Osdahl, Channel 4 Action News.
Powerful story there. We want to pass along a couple of notes on the story for you. First, a cleanup has been ongoing in the community now for 2 decades.
Also, attorneys for the plaintiffs say more lawsuits could be on the way.